To start, take a PVC T and make a hole at the center. Now take 3 gear DC motors, apply some double-sided tape around them. Insert the wires through the hole. And fit all the 3 motors in the mouth of the PVC T. Make sure that the motor at the junction is slightly bulged out. Now, connect the 2 opposite motors according to the schematic. That is, connect the positive wire of one motor with the negative wire of the other motor. Take another PVC T and a piece of cardboard. Draw few circles of diameter equal to that of the PVC T. Cut all the circles carefully. Using hot glue, paste them together to make 3 equal stacks. Make sure to apply hot glue around the edges to get a rubber-like grip. Apply some hot glue and fix all the 3 stacks in the mouth of PVC T. You can also use a piece of cork or plastic caps to fill in the mouth. Now carefully apply hot glue to seal the gaps on all the 3 sides. Mark the center of all the 3 sides. Drill a hole at the mark points. Now using hot glue, attach the PVC-T to the motor shaft. Take a straw and a wooden stick. Insert the straw through the holes in the PVC-T. Cut the straw and the stick of adequate length. Using hot glue, attach the wheels on both the sides of the wooden stick. Also attach the wheels to the motor shafts. It is now time to make a remote control for the car. Take a general purpose PCB board and few office clips. Unfold the clips. And using pliers, cut the smaller part to get 8 similar pieces. Now insert the clips in the PCB board. Solder them really well so that the copper does not wear off. Insert the cells to verify the size. Now connect the terminals so that all the cells are in series connection. Take 2 DPDT switches. Insert both the switches on the opposite sides. And solder them to the PCB board. We also need to provide support to the cells from both sides. For that, take an office clip and make it straight. Slightly bend the edges. Insert the clip to both the sides on the PCB board. We have a nicely enclosed cell holder. Refer to the schematic and make connection between the cell holder and the switch. Now take the car and 4 different color wires. Connect all the 4 wires to the motors. Refer to the schematic and connect the car to the remote control. To secure the connections, cover the remote with the insulation tape. Our remote controlled stunt car is ready to be used. Insert the cells and have fun. This car is not only very fast, but also can drift well with some practice and control. So guys, this here concludes the tutorial. Do come back soon for new ones. If you liked watching the video, hit like and share it with your friends. You can also subscribe to my channel for regular updates. Thanks for watching.